Hey YouTube friends, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is LaDonna and I'm a first year homeschooling mom. And in today's video, I am totally jumping on the bandwagon and sharing with you what I'm gonna put in my kiddos' stocking. So like I said, I have two. My oldest son, he's 10, his name's David. Here's his stocking. We've had these stockings for quite a few years. I think after my daughter was born, actually, I had them made. And then this is Annabeth's stocking. She is 8. So I have an 8-year-old and a 10-year-old. You know, I just like to put fun stuff in their stocking. I don't necessarily overdo it, but I just fill it. And once it's filled, that's it. So let's just go ahead and jump in. I'll share with you my 10-year-old son stocking. So, and I'm gonna try not to be too bumpy. I'm at my dining room table. I'm trying something different this time because the lighting is really good out my back door. So both of my kiddos, they each get socks. Now, you can see that this is the Goodfellow sock brand from Target. And if you know anything about the Goodfellow brand, you know that is their brand, their clothing brand for men. My 10-year-old son grew out of youth shoes this past summer. He is now in a he now wears a 7.5 in men's. Totally blew my mind, totally shocked us. I remember when it finally hit me that he needed to go into a men's shoe because I was in the youth department, and I'm like, why don't they have a 7? Where's a 7? And then I realized that it stops. That he had to move up. So anyway, he desperately needed new socks. They get socks anyway, but let me just go ahead and say, adult socks are more than kids' socks. So it was kind of like that reality of, wow, we have reached a new chapter in his life, and Lord help me. So anyway, this is going in his stocking. It's 10 pairs. I know he's going to be really excited about it. I know that sounds funny, but he has been asking for some new socks. So anyway, the next thing that's going into his stocking, it's a pack of these Pokemon trading cards. He's really into Pokemon. He's been into Pokemon for probably 2 years now, and he probably has all of the ones that are in here, but he just loves to get new cards. He collects them, and this is actually, this little pack is a game. It's got the little pieces in here for him to play, so I kind of thought this would be good while we're traveling. We do live away from our family, so we travel in the summer and for holidays, obviously not this year because of COVID, but instead of him going through his little binder and trying to figure out what he wants to bring, what he doesn't want to bring, I thought that this would just be neat because we could leave everything in this little case and I can put it in his backpack for when we're on the go. So that's going in his stocking. The other thing that's going into his stocking, and like I said, he's 10, so we're in that in-between phase where he's starting to grow out of toys. So he's not necessarily asking for those kinds of gifts anymore. So I've really had to get creative. Anyway, long story short, I found this hex bug at Target for, I think it was like $14. I'm just gonna put that in there, and I know he'll have a lot of fun with it. It's a remote control thing. He doesn't have the sets or anything, but just something fun, something different for him. I also got 3 books for each of my children. Target, they were having a buy 2, get 1 free sale. So they'll each get 3 books. The first one, hopefully I'm not shaking the camera. The first one I got is The Dog Man, Grime and Punishment. So he's a big Dog Man fan. He has been for a couple of years. He's, again, fixing to grow out of this. So I just kind of wanted to make the most of it. But this is not like new, but it's new to him and he doesn't have this one. So I'm really excited about that. So that's gonna go into his stocking. I also went ahead and picked up one of The Last Kids on Earth. This is the third one. So I think he had the first one or the second one. I think it's the second one. So anyway, he had gotten that one from a book fair last year when he was in school. And I just wanted to pick him up the next one. So He really likes them. The last one that I got, and this is the one that he has the first one, it's called Wings of Fire. It's a graphic novel. And it was one of the ones he had gotten from a book fair too. It's a lot like Dogman, where it's the comic feel. Anyway, those are their books. I just wanted to make it fun, and like I said, it was a good sale at Target. Each of my kiddos, I'm gonna put some candy in their stocking. Just some candy that I picked up from the dollar store. They really love these nerd ropes. And I try to make it even between the both of them so that there's not any, you know, well, she got more than me, he got more than me. Does anybody out there know what I'm talking about? Do your kids do that, or is it just mine? So anyway, they each get 3 candies, and, you know, I try to give them the same amount of goodie. So anyway, that is my 10-year-old son's stocking. My 8-year-old daughter's stocking, here's her pack of socks. As you can see, they're bright and colorful, and she would not settle for anything less. She's definitely into anything that is alive. She loves color, she loves sparkle, she loves character, all of those things. So those are her socks, which are quite fun. The next thing I picked her up were this cute little pack of 3 scrunchies. So she's totally into that. These are, you know, by the dollar section in Target. This was actually $3, but, you know, it's $1 a scrunchie. Anyway, blue, fuzzy. This fuzzy one has cat ears on it, so I knew she would love that. But she's 8, and she's getting to that point where that's what she wants in her hair, or she wants to wear it on her wrist. So just something fun that I could stick in there. The next thing that I saw at Target that I thought was super cute, and I know that she will love, was this fuzzy little journal. The tag's still on there, but look, it's a little dog, and it's even got a little tail in the back. It's not locked or anything, but it's just blank with the little pictures of the dogs on it. But she is an animal lover. She loves cats and dogs and all things animals. Her favorite show is the Dr. Pole show, if that kind of helps you out with just her interest. Yes, I know that there's a lot that is on the Dr. Pole show. We don't watch too much of all of the things cows, but the other stuff she really enjoys. Her next thing that I'm going to show you are her 3 books that I picked up from Target, and again, it was the same deal. It was buy 2 get 1 free. This one is called The Royal Rescues: The Lost Puppy. So I thought that would be super cute. She's just started reading these smaller chapter books, so anything that really encourages her or gives her confidence, I'm totally on board for. She already has one of these books from this Cutie Corn series, but this is the Rainy Day Rescue, and she really enjoys these too. Again, if you can see the theme with the animals, but that's totally what she loves. And what I really like about this, the book, she's reading one right now. After she gets done reading it, she comes and tells me about it. So anytime she shows that kind of interest, I'm just gonna go ahead and just jump on board and encourage it as much as I can. And then the next one, this is a new to us series. It's the Unicorn Princesses and the Moonbeans. This is book 9. As you can see, that you can kind of see on the back that there are more series, but again, unicorns in there. She's a dog lover, a cat lover, a horse lover. She's a unicorn lover, so I just thought that she would really enjoy that. And then again, she's got her candy, just like her brother. They really love these nerd ropes. I don't know if your kids love the nerd ropes, but anyway, that's what's in their stocking. I would love to know what you are going to put in your children's stocking this year. Do you have a theme? Do you put fun stuff? Do you put practical stuff? How do you approach it? I would love to know in the comments below. Anyway, friends, thanks for stopping by. I hope this encouraged you if you are still shopping, and I will see you soon. Bye.